Morning, everyone. Welcome to morning meditation. Just wait 5 minutes for everybody to come online. Just have some morning flute music on. Himalayan flute music. So settle down into meditation. So good morning again, everyone. Let us all bow down to Sri Mataji, raise our kundalini and put on abundance. Now let us all say one mantra to Sri Ganesha. Om Tvameva Sakshat Sri Ganesha Sakshat Sri Adi Shakti Mataji Sri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. I now have a puja talk from 1992 from the United States, and it's about stop feeling guilty. Sri Vishnumaya puja talk.
Sri Krishna's power is of Mahalakshmi. So Mahalakshmi principle is such that where seeking is important. Vishnu principle is there when Sri Lakshmi is his power. After getting the Lakshmi up to a certain, then you jump into a new awareness or a new sort of a seeking, which is the seeking of the spirit, where the Mahalakshmi principle starts, the central part. That far, of course, in America, it started, the Mahalakshmi principle. But people did not know. They had no discretion to know which way to go for their seeking. And so many got enamored by false advertisements, but all kinds of promises, claims and things. And I came here long time back at that moment where I knew that the seeking now is showing results and that all the people from all over the world will try to come down here because there was a market for them. And their marketing will start in such a manner that these people who are used to marketing would fall into it. I came, I tried, I told them. Just call me. is exactly what happened in America. That I came here, I think I was the first to arrive. I warned them, I told them names of the people who will be doing all this kind of work. Also, I told them what were they in their last lives, what kind of a thing they did, what kind of work they did, what are their negative powers, and how they try to manipulate. But nobody would listen to me. Because these people found out that the weaknesses of Americans, if you can pamper them, pamper their ego, and tell them that this is something very important that you should do, something that is very superficial, but something looks fantastic. As I told you that, they said you can fly 3 feet height. And the Americans took to it. All such absurd ideas, they took to it. Because they thought it was something new, something different. And they wouldn't listen to me because I said I won't take money. And they told me very clearly that nobody will understand you if you don't take money. So I said, how much will you pay me? This is so invaluable. How much money are you going to pay me? And they had no answer. People who were still money-oriented, so the Mahalakshmi principle was not in them to understand that if you have to see the people, you cannot pay for it. They couldn't understand. And that is how they had to go through all this circle of facing all kinds of falsehoods, all superficial things. Ultimately, now, I think, first year I feel everything has come up very well. But one of the chakras of this vision is a very important vision. And the left vision in the center, if it is caught up, you get angina, you get spondylitis, and also you get lethargic organs. So this left vishuddhi has been a sort of a fashion with the Western. Maybe because of Christianity, where you have to confess, and you have to say you are a sinner, and you are a born sinner, or original sinner, all kinds of things. But you are branded as sinner, which you always felt it. And that need was built in to the left. I think this is one of the greatest drawbacks even today, that people in America feel extremely guilty for very small things, because they have no confidence in themselves. Firstly, they think that we had no tradition. Basically, they may look arrogant, they may look to be very show-offs, but basically, inside, they feel that we have had no tradition. We are a very young nation. Like, they think that the English are too over-sophisticated, or the French are very sophisticated, and we are not compared to their primitive. This kind of a funny ideas they have. And because of this, you see, they try to make up. To make it up, the path they followed ended up into all kinds of things, and it built up a very huge deficit. That's why Americans are having so many problems of the deficit. First of all, this center catches. When you do not want to face your mistakes, I've committed the mistakes, all right, I've committed it, now I'm not going to do it, and why I committed, and why it happened, just face it. They don't want to. They will feel guilty that we have done this sort of thing. Like they go on amassing, like very black clouds of guilt. Then this Vishnu Maya, who is the thunder, or we can call, who is the electrical charge which is liberated, by the friction of these black clouds, which actually is a catalyst for rain. It's a catalyst for rain. This start acting on such a moment. That is, they suddenly get a shock. They become extremely sensitive. They get nervous. And this nervousness makes them think, why are we nervous? What is the problem? Like the exposure of their heat comes through the Vishnumaya bar. I have to tell you about also the origin of Vishnumaya, which is very interesting. Vishnumaya was the sister of Sri Krishna, who was born after Sri Krishna was born. Actually, she was not his own sister, but she was the daughter of Nanda. And when Sri Krishna was taken over and was put in the care of Nanda and Yashoda, they gave their own daughter in his place. And the father of Shri Krishna brought it back. So, when Kansa came, you all know about the story, to ask about the eighth child, they said, this is the child. He said, but this is not a man, this is a woman. He took the child in his hand and did like this and threw it in the sky. And there she went. And there she announced that Shri Krishna is already incarnated, is living, and he is your killer. So she is the announcer. She is the announcer of the incarnation. She is the announcer of something good that is going to happen. Also, she is the one who can burn things which are not spiritually all right. At the time of Mahabharata, she was born as Draupadi. And this Draupadi was the sister of Sri Rama. And when, as you know, in Mahabharata, all of you know the story of Mahabharata, I need not tell that. Duryodhana tried to take out her clothes. Then she called for Krishna. First she said, Kree, then put her feet like this. Till she said, Krishna, it was there. Because she was thinking, if she says, Shna, it will fall down and she will become exposed. As soon as she said Krishna, the thing fell down. And that's the time Sri Rama came, all the Sri Krishna came all the way from Dwarka. And Tulsidas ji has described it very well in Hindi language. Dwarka Mishora Bhayo. In Dwarka, there was a big noise, you can call it, or I don't know, Shora Bhayo. Shore of Ayurveda, tremendous, what you call, thunder. Because she was the one who is responsible for thunder. Shore of Ayurveda, Shakh, Chakra, Gada, Padma, Garuda, Laista. With the Shankha, with Chakra, with Garuda, with Padma. All of them, he came on the Garuda. With all his weapons, he came on a Garuda to help her. He started supplying the saris to her, and this Duryodhana got absolutely, Dushasana got absolutely tired and fell on the ground. So now here Vishnumaya is the one who is the virgin. Not only that, she is the virgin, but she exists in all the five elements. As shown that she married five Pandavas. And that This power of Argentina chose to expose people to the dangers of these horrible Kauravas who were going to rule and destroy the Dharma. So she stood back. And she's the one who said that you have to fight. You have to fight for Dharma, whatever we have. And Krishna always supported her. So as a brother, Sri Krishna supported her. So the relationship between brother and sister are very important in India. Also should be with Sajogis, because we have Lakshmi Bandhan. We also have what you call the Maya Beach, where on Diwali day, I am a Rakhi to the brother. Now this Rakhi is nothing but the Vishnu Maya's power, which protects the brother. Actually there the brother protected her and now the sister's love protects them. So the relationship between the brother and sister is much more important than any other relationship, because it's so pure, it's so protective, it's so loving, and also it is of an equal age. For example, between the parents and the children, cannot be that. I say, between the grandparents and the children can be quite imbalanced also. But between the brother and sister, they have the same age group, same understanding. And this relationship is maintained by this Vishnu Maya. We have a very good incident of that in India, which I must tell you how it's Rakhi Bandhan. Or this relationship between brother and sister is respected. I mean, nobody will believe, because in these countries where there is no relationship which is respected, we won't understand. But when Alexander the Great came to India, he conquered our country quite a lot. But there was one king who defeated him and put him in jail. Alexander had married an Indian king. So it was a day of this Rakhi Purnima. She put one Rakhi in one plate and covered it up and sent it to this king. So they said, a Rakhi has come. So the king said, all right, tie up the Rakhi. He didn't know whose Rakhi it was. When it was tied, he said, whose Rakhi it was? It's your sister's. Who is my sister? She is the wife of this king, Alexander. Oh my God. How could I do such a thing? He is my brother. He immediately went to the jail. I am prostrated before him. I'm sorry. Whatever. This is the graciousness, you understand. How could I be so stupid as to arrest you? Alexander was flabbergasted. He couldn't understand his reaction. He said, what's this going on? And he said that now, I ask for your forgiveness and please come out. Great pomp and show with ornaments for his sister and all that. He sent the brother-in-law home. Now this Alexander could not understand. He went in and his wife was smiling. He said, what's the matter? How am I here? She said, do you know, I have saved you with one thread. He showed you around. This thread you saved me how? She said, you know what is today? Is the day when a sister can tie this to a brother and the brother has to do what sister wants. So I said, I sent it to this guru, the king, and he has released. Alexander thought, what sort of people these Indians are? On one thread they release such an enemy like me. How can I rule these people? They put me out any time, so symbolic they are. He said, all right, I'm sorry. He took one fellow called Vardai, Chanda Vardai, took him down. He was a poet with him. And he said, now you write poetry, because Indians are very subtle people. I can't understand. How can they release such a horrible enemy like me, only on a thread? Such trust, such understanding of a brother or a sister. And the sister has to keep the trust also. So now when we go deeper into it and see for ourselves our Vishuddhi problems is this, that we always try in the West to feel guilty and get out of our mistakes. For small, small things we need. Because the norms in the Western life are so rigid, like if you put a spoon on the other side, finished. I mean, what does it matter? You can take it on this side and eat it. If you spill some coffee, then that guilt will last all your life. After all, coffee is spilled. If it is hot, it can happen, some accident can take place. The guilt business is so great that nobody corrects oneself with the spoon feeling guilty, 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 guilty. And all the subtleties of life you start missing. In circle, especially, to feel guilty means all your left side is caught up. You cannot feel the vibrations properly because this is the cervical, the one which your guilt is sitting and is just clamping it. You cannot feel the left side. You start clutching on the left side till you receive some sort of a horrible disease. Then you realize. The subtler part of this Vishnu Maya is that she knows the truth. When she shines, you can see everything. Even for a short time, she exposes in the darkness. Then, in the same way, when Vishnu Maya starts acting on you, then she exposes the truth. But supposing you continue with your left Vishuddhi too much, then she just disappears. She is not there to correct you, to help you in any way, or to expose you. Then you don't feel it. You become numb on the left side, absolutely numb on the left side. And the left side is known as the indicator of all kinds of left side. This is one of the reasons that we have the maximum number of left-sided diseases in the West than in India. Indian diseases are from right side, while the left-sided diseases come from this left side. So to feel it itself is wrong and is a difficult. Now you feel it for some. What's the sense of feeling it? It's just a myth. It's an empty thing you are carrying upon yourself. No use feeling it. If you think you have done something wrong, just face it. That I have done this wrong and I will not do it again. But if you feel guilty, then you see it's like a stored up stuff there. And then again you do the same mistake. Again you do the same mistake. And you become immune. Immunity you develop. Then we start not even feeling that it is wrong. You know? People do wrong things. Even without thinking that it is wrong. Even that consciousness, or you can say that alertness, is finished. Then you think, what's wrong? For anything, this is a very good answer, what's wrong? It's like a drunkard. He starts drinking. First he feels, oh, I should not have drunk. Then he starts little bit more. Ultimately, he says, what's wrong? If I'm drinking, it's perfect. Anything of that kind starts with left vision. Because we do not face the mistake. It's not true that because your tradition has been very short or anything, it's only thing your attitude. Because it is Krishna's place, especially for Americans, it is very important to face their mistakes. And to admit, all right, I have done this mistake and I am not going to. So because they do not want to admit, they put up this arrogant behavior I know underneath this arrogant there's somebody who's very good. They are actually here very collective also, very collective. In the sense they will be worried about Vietnam, Korea, everything. Anything happens in the world, they are worried about. They are the ones who started UN and every sort of thing. Everything is there. But despite all that, this guilt business makes them very insensitive. Very insensitive to things which are reality. Anything which is negative, they should face that thing as negative that they don't face. They will support a country which is despotic, despite the fact they are democratic. All such things. Not only in politics, but also in day-to-day life. Then the whole thing becomes such a lifestyle. It becomes a lifestyle. The whole thing becomes collective. Nobody ever can come and say that this is something we are doing wrong, I wish to stop. If somebody says that, or they say he's mad. No good. For Freud, I was telling you that Freud was denounced by many people and people gave some papers, everything happened, but nobody would listen to them. And the same thing happened with surgeons. They would not listen to me because they have developed an immunity against reality. In everything, whatever is real, they don't want to face it. That's too much. Much too much for them. With this kind of attitude, they had to work out something else, and in that, they have gone to the right side. With that, they have developed all kind of machinery, science, all these things. But science is not conclusive. It cannot be the totality, it cannot be the reality. So, this Vishnu Maya shows her strength. She does lots of things by which people are frightened. She can enter into any element. She can permeate. Supposing she enters into a water element, she can create a typhoon. She can create any kind of disaster, she can enter into Mother Earth and she can create an earthquake. She can do anything because she has a power to enter into anything. You know that she can enter into Mother Earth very easily. She can enter into water very easily. And when she gets into it, she becomes the catalyst. And all these problems that you are facing today in America are because of the because of Vishnu Maya. I'm happy today's program has been arranged for Vishnu Maya. Because this is the power which you, Sahajogi, should be able to harness and should be able to worship. So that she sees all of you there and she looks after you and she maintains your life and looks after you. Now the most difficult thing is to convince people in America that money is not a thing. You may have any amount of money, you may have any amount of so-called pleasures, everything, but still, you can never be satisfied and you can never be at with yourself, and you cannot generate peace. Money cannot replace reality. It's just there. Now, the problem is that people become so addicted to this money that all value systems start going down. I was surprised. I knew somebody here prostitution. So I said, what's wrong? You get money. So whatever can get money, they indulge it. So there's no chastity, which is the basics, which is the foundation of human beings. As a result, when you insert this virginity of Ishtamaya, then the Maya means the, her play is that you get AIDS, you get all kinds of other diseases which are incurable and which are what you can call as the secret disease. Because she is the virgin, and because she respects the virginity, and those who go against, not that virginity is meant only for women, also meant for men, because everybody has early left vision. Here the idea is that only the virginity is word used for women only. It's not. Even the men who do not respect their virginity, their chastity, are attacked by Vishnumaya in different ways. I am not surprised that Los Angeles, they say, is in danger all the time. Because of your cinemas, you produce all these things you produce. Of course, I mean, now with the Sahaja Yoga being established very well in Los Angeles, maybe avert, but still, it's very dangerous. It's the one of the most powerful Shakti is this of Ishtamaya. Because she plays the illusion, she creates the Maya also. Also, she breaks the Maya, and she can burn anything. Your forest is burning now, 65 hectares of land is burning. Who has done this? It's nothing but Ishtamaya. Nobody has to take any matchbox for that. She can burn anything. And her burning gives you the feeling that if there's an electrical charge, as if burned with electrical charge. This is very true. In so many cases I've seen, those who came to me with problems of electricity, that they said that you think there's some electrical charge coming out of you. It's the burning of an electrical shock. This is Vishnumaya's doing, and she's the one who is the corrector. She corrects. Don't feel it. Face your problems. It's sort of when we hide our mistakes in the name of guilt, when we try to camouflage it, she's the one who exposes it on individual level, on collective level, on national level, international level. Because she can permeate into anything. And this permeation of hers gives her such subtleties. But people cannot relate disaster to their mistakes. They cannot. They don't understand why such a disaster has taken place. What has happened? There was a big typhoon that came up to a point and suddenly turned towards Kauai. Now, what was the reason for that? To go and hit Kauai. In Kauai, there's a Swayambhu of Shiva. It's a fact. People are making money out of it, quite a lot of money, and deceiving people. There's big business going on in the name of Shiva. So, Kauai was it, not Hawaii so much as Kauai. And it turned suddenly. No one can understand. So all these thundering things that are coming from nature, anything, whether it is earthquake or it is landslide or it could be floods or it could be typhoon, anything is the work of this Vishnu mind. Or we can say all natural catastrophes are brought about by this Vishnu Maya. She has this power. This is the only way we can shock. But despite all that shocking, people have to relate these disasters to their mistakes that they have committed and have vastly kept it in a thought place. I've heard from some Indian students that when they came to America, some boys asked them to take drugs and do all other things also. So they wouldn't do this. Yeah, could do this, this, that. You know, they just popped it into their head that you have to do it. You are cowards, you cannot do it and all. So some of them said, all right, we'll try. But what surprised them, that they knew it was wrong, while those who were telling them never thought it was wrong. They thought they have been great martyrs, or they have been liberators, and they have got liberties. They couldn't understand this. This kind of liberty that they were boasting of was so destructive. They never understood that this is destructive. So once your left foot is absolutely jammed, you lose complete discretion of the chakra here, which we call it Hamsa chakra. And then you do not know what is destructive, what is constructive. You start accepting mostly the destructive thing if your left foot is bad. Escape. So what? What wrong? That is how violence has come. That is how all kind of cheating, corruption has come. What's wrong? Because if you do anything wrong, you put it there, finished, stored up. Again, you do anything, you put it there. And till you become absolutely immune to all destructive action, you go on. So to get out of it, what to do? To get out of this horrible state where you do not feel any thing wrong, what is the thing is only is to take the surgery in a right fashion. First of all, you must face yourself. If you start facing yourself, you realize that you have committed a mistake. So this is the mistake I've committed. Doesn't matter. I am not going to feel guilty about it. If I ever have to do this, I will not do it. And I am not guilty for what has happened. Is the past finished? With this faith in yourself, you can definitely get rid of your left foot. The problem is, even if I tell you something, I am worried that you start feeling guilty about it. I mean, I am telling you for something for your correction. Then you start guilty. Mother is saying so, she, I did this and other, that you did. At this moment, what I'm telling you, never to do it again. And face it. Whatever you did is finished and gone and is forgiven. Otherwise, Vishnu Maya will take it. This is very important, because one side is a leela, it's a play, and it's all the world is beautiful. The another side is the guilt. So we think that by just feeling guilty, we are solving all our problems. And this side, we are enjoying ourselves. And this, the guilt part is just like a storehouse of a garbage. But we never think this garbage, what it is wrong, it's wrong. And this is what it is, that Vishnu Maya has to burn this garbage. Then she works in her own ways, in her own Maya ways, and so many things happen. Like there was a lady And she was very right-sided. She used to dominate everyone, but nobody dared tell her that, because if you tell her, she would come back on you. So nobody wanted to tell her what's wrong with her. They said, all right, let it be. But I told her that, see, you're very right-sided, you're dominating everyone, everybody is right enough. So she said, no, mother, I am not. All right, I have to. You better believe me or you are in for trouble. And that very day, she was getting down from the staircase and she fell from top to bottom. And on her right side, she gave to mother, her right hand is broken, my right leg is broken, this is broken, that is broken. I said, then you know what happened. I now know why it has happened. Then I cured her. She was all right. But what I'm trying to tell you, that she won't listen to me. So the right-sided people have a special capacity to put everything in. So I always say that it is the byproduct of ego. Those people who try to dominate, who try to be angry, try to control everyone, they put it down there. And then the whole thing works against them. This is to be understood in a very serious manner. That feeling guilty is not that you are harming yourself, but you are harming all of us. Also, this Vishnu Maya gets very upset with two other things. One of the things is smoke. If you smoke too much, then this Vishnu Maya gets very angry. She is the one who then causes cancer. She can spoil your throat. When all kinds of ear, nose, throat problems can come in with the smoke. Because she doesn't like that smoke. She once, twice, thrice. But once you start smoking, then after some time, oh, what's wrong? They will quote, such and such man who is 83, he still smokes. See, quoting like this, they have ideas like this. Then you have also some cinema heroes. Such and such man, see, he murdered his wife, he's not, he's going around. So we should also murder. We should also smoke. So the all ideas which have destroyed themselves become our ideas. And we start exactly doing what they are doing, without knowing that how they are destroyed, we also destroy. So, this understanding about Vishnu Maya's powers should be there with us. That if we try to continue with our mistakes and putting them here, then first thing, we become vulnerable to all kinds of things. With that, if you are smoking, you can become also very much vulnerable to cancer of the throat. Another thing which people do not know is the mantras. If you go on saying any mantra, I mean, in India, there are people who will every day morning get up and say some mantra for about, say, 100 times. Some say it at least 300 times, 500 times. They go on mentioning mantra, 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 like that. Now, she's the mantra. She's the one who gives the power to the mantra. Now, if you are not connected to this divine power, then there's a short circuit. And if you go on saying this mantra, you develop all the troubles of the throat, throat cancer. You can develop also stomach problems, because it is Krishna and Vishnu are the same. You might develop also the problem of Virata. Because you are reciting a mantra like this, you see, a telephone. If it is not connected I go on using it, the telephone will go out of order. In the same way, if you are doing wrong mantras, in the sense that the mantras which are said before your connection with the divine, then they can spoil your refuge. This is the style they use in India. Supposing you are a businessman in India. Now, you are a big businessman, you have made a lot of money, now you feel guilty about it. Because you have made by bad means also, by all kinds of black market and all sorts of stuff. So they make a big temple of Vishnu. Not Vishuddhi, but they make a very big temple of Shri Vishnu. And they create a kind of image that they are going to just. Or they'll have hierarchies, then they distribute food to people or distribute some things to people and feel satisfied. Here you go on committing any amount of sins, any amount of nonsense. And then out of that money, you make a little contribution to Shri Vishnu, thinking that Shri Vishnu will be very happy and will not punish him. But he is Kubera, what can you give it to him? He is the Kubera. He gives you all the money, he does everything. So how can you give anything to Kubera, who is himself the Lord of wealth? It's a very common thing in India, like there was a Bhutan thing. I knew of a man who was very corrupt, very bad person. I mean, really, he was really very, very bad man. And he had taken away so much land from the poor farmers and all that. So he gave one land to Mahatma Gandhi. And this land, this Bhutan land was known, which was, I think, nobody gave. This land was so bad that you could not put even cactus. And he was telling everybody, I have given so much land to Bhutan, I have given so much land. So trying to sort of justify himself for taking all the land from the poor and lynching them and then to do this kind of a generosity. So this is another escape you have. Then do what you like and ultimately be generous. This kind of gracious covering of your mistakes can be very misleading. It doesn't work with Vishnu Maya. She knows you out and out. And if you try all these tricks with her, she will show her own powers. I would say all our left side problems come because of Vishnu Maya power. She punishes you, as well as she exposes, as well as she gives you light, as well as she corrects you. With all these powers of Vishnu Maya, which we will have,
yeah, we'll leave that talk here, and we'll now say one mantra to Sri Vishnu Maya. Om Tvameva Saksha Sri Vishnu Maya Saksha Sri Adi Shakti Mataji Sri Nirmala Devi Namo. Let us all continue in meditation, and when you're ready, please bow down, Srimatiji, raise your kundalini and put on a bandhan. I'll put on some music. Goodbye for today.
selling on Amazon, it was found out of every six people, three make $5,000 a month.